Hi, welcome once again. This is a series of three videos. Today we are going to learn different methods to make things float in water through physics simulation. Things behave differently in water, so cloth, for example, behaves differently than a boat. So a cloth tries to follow the waves, while a heavy object like a boat doesn't sway that much with the waves. A box would behave even differently, due to less surface area. So we'll start with the ball, so there is a ball. The moment we play, the ball drops and sinks in water. It's not floating in the water. And now let's see how we can make it from scratch, so that the ball floats. So in the content browser, let's make a new blueprint. We'll right-click under blueprint class, let's make an actor, and let's name it BP Float Ball. And now let's open it by double-clicking. So the first thing it needs is a static mesh or basic shape sphere, which will be ball. So under components, we'll click and add in sphere. Then add some random material to it for better visual appeal. Now compile and go to the viewport. Here now drag the BP float ball onto the water near to the previous ball. And then play. The new ball don't react, whereas the old ball drops and sinks. Here we have to simulate the physics, so go back to the BP float ball and simulate physics under the physics section of details panel. Click on the mass also. Now compile again and play, this time BTH the balls drop and sink. Now we have to add buoyancy component. Go back to the BP flat and click on add new component. Then add something called buoyancy. Buoyancy component helps anything to float on water. Now if you compile and play, and check what happens. Now both the balls sank. So stop playing and go back to the blueprint float ball. After selecting buoyancy, go to the pontoons points. So we have added the buoyancy component. Now our ball will have a force. So to apply the buoyant force, we need to define where we want the force to act, and we'll do that under buoyancy. So pontoons are where that force is applied. To try at some value on the z-axis. And compile and play. So this is still not working. Let's check again. Okay, the step we forgot was this. We need to make the ball as the default scene route. Now compile again and play. This time it's working. The old ball sinks, whereas the new ball floats. However, this seems a bit static. And not giving appeal as floating. So after some alteration in pontoons, compile again and play. Pontoons are the points which represents the plane, parallel to water, on which the body will float. So we can alter X, Y, or Z axis based on our requirement. Now compile again and play. This is working fine. So far was good, now let's make a boat float, which will be a bit different from a ball floating. So again in the content browser. Let's make a new blueprint. So right-click on the content browser and select blueprint class. And then let's make an actor and let's name it BP Boat. And now let's open it by double-clicking. So the first thing it needs is a static mesh, which will be boat. So under components, we'll click add static mesh. Now after selecting the static mesh component, in the details panel, go to the mesh. Look for a boat, and select it. This mesh has been downloaded already into the project. These 3D mesh are quite available. Now go down, and in the physics section, enable the simulate physics and add mass to the mesh. And do forget to make the static mesh as default route. Now add a buoyancy component. Now compile and in the viewport add the beep boat over the water. And now play. Both the ball and boat sink. So we have added the buoyancy component. So here again we have to apply the pontoons. So pontoons are the areas where that force is applied, and we can add as many as we want. Here in this case we will apply 4 pontoon points. So click the plus sign 4 times to create 4 pontoons points. So to make the reference, we will add arrow component. We would adjust the location of arrow component on the 4 sides of the boat. And then we will copy the location of the 4 arrows onto the 4 pontoons. Now that all 4 arrows are placed perfectly. Now copy the location and paste the same on all different pontoons like this. Once the pontoon locations are set, compile and play. Now it's working fine. The boat is reacting to the wave force, and the dragging can be adjusted by modifying the mass of the boat. Anyway, you can delete the arrows, as they were the reference only. Compile it and play. Here we are with the perfectly floating boat.
Hope this video helps you to initiate your journey into the creative world of Unreal Engine. Please like this video if you find it helpful and informative, and subscribe to our channel for newer updates and game development tutorials. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.